So in the previous class, we discussed about phase local loops. Right. So in continuation that, actually we are discussing the grid integration of these battery chargers or these active rectifiers. So several methods we discussed. So one of the commonly used method is the decoupled current control. Decoupled current control method. Right. So we already discussed the different types of basic methods like regular current control method, conventional current control method, and voltage control method. We also discussed about the two different types of current control methods. One is with synchronous PI and other with conventional PI. So in continuation that, so let us assume that, so this is the grid voltage or the grid. And we have this inverter. So this is grid VG, ABC, there is a grid voltages, and say it is RS. And this is LS, and this is inverter, and here on the DC side we have something is there on the DC side. It may be a PV or it may be some load or it may be any kind of thing what you are trying to integrate into the grid, right? So let us assume that, so here we have two buses, so this is VGABC and this is we can say that this is inverter terminals, so VT, ABC. Okay, so this is the grid voltages and these are the inverter voltages or inverter terminal voltages. Right, so this is voltage source and this is another voltage source. Right, but the power is feeding from either in this direction from the grid to the load or in this direction. So that all depends on so which applications you are considering, right? If it is a PV, so in that case the power flow is like this. In case of load, so in this case the power flow is from the grid to the inverter, right? If there is no change in the controller, there is no change in the controller whether it is feeding the positive power or feeding the negative power, the control remains same. So only thing when it is feeding that, the reference will be P, or when it is feeding the grid, the reference will be P, or when it is feeding the load, it may be minus P. Only that the sign will change. So rest of the things will remain same. So let us assume that, so these are the currents. So that is IT, A, B, C. These are the terminal currents of the inverter. Clear? So this is our voltage source and this is another voltage source. Clear? If you want the power flow from this grid to the load side or the load side to the grid, so this should be, there is some phase displacement should be there between these two, right? So that means it will be something like this. If this is the grid voltage and this inverter voltage will be something like this, right? If you have phase shift, so then only the power flow will be happen, right? So in this particular case, so what is the power flow equation? What is the power flow equation here? What is the power flow equation?
VGVT.
VGVT.
By
this Z into
sine
of this difference angle, right?
Yes.
This angle is theta. So approximately we can write like this, right? Okay. Clear? So whatever, this is voltage source and this is also another voltage source. We are trying to count these two voltage sources in parallel. So therefore, the rest of the voltage drop between these two, so that will be taken care by these two elements, right? So whenever there is inductor or this present, so then only this power flow will happen. So to have a power flow, so this inductor must, right? So either, so sometimes if it is a grid is there, so we need to connect some transformer, but after that we have this inverter. So in this case, so we have to make sure that this transformer is having some leakage inductance, right? So we have to make sure that this leakage inductance is sufficient for this power flow. If it is not sufficient, so we need to add some additional inductor. Clear? If you are using a transformer when you are connecting to a grid, so you need to use the leakage inductance of the transformer for this power flow. If that leakage inductance is not sufficient, you need to connect some additional inductor in series with the transformer. So if you apply KVL, so for this equation, so how it will be? So this is VG ABC. This is equal to, right? So this is RS into I. This is T ABC plus. So this is LS into D IT ABC by DT. So what you left here now is V inverter, or this V, not this, this VT ABC. It's clear. So you're aware this VG ABC is, it consists of a three variables, that is VGA and VGC. Clear. So these variables are in ABC reference frame. So we need to transform these variables into alpha beta reference frame. From alpha beta reference frame, again, we need to transform into DQ reference frame. Okay. So if you transform into alpha beta reference frame first, so that is three phase to two phase transformation. So this is VG alpha beta. Assume that, so this is the balanced voltages, and that zero term is not present. So this RS into I T alpha beta, this is LS into D I T alpha beta by DT, plus this is VT alpha beta. So here this alpha beta are orthogonal, and these are complex variables, right? So these are complex variables. So after that, we need to transform this into DQ reference frame. Directly we can do that. So from ABC to DQ. So how this equation changes when you have transformed DQ reference frame? So how this equation changes? So this will become VZ DQ. This is the grid voltages equal to RS I T DQ, and come to this one. So how this one will changes? How this one will changes?
Zero.
That is not zero, right? This one is VT DQ, right? So how this variable changes? How this one changes? No idea. So this is, you might have studied that, right? Speed vector, you have heard of speed vector in machine modeling. You might have studied this, right? Speed vector. Okay then. Right.
Sir, you're saying you're talking about the speed of the reference frame.
Yeah, not speed of the reference frame. When your model and inductance, okay, in flux linkages form, so you will get some matrix. So that coupling matrix will be there, right? Okay, I will try to derive that. So let us assume that it is there in PC crossbook, I think. So let us assume that we are talking about this one, right? Okay, so this inductance, that is flux linkages, this is lambda equal to L into I, right? Agree?
Yes, sir.
From this, we can write like this. This is P lambda ABC. Okay, this is P lambda ABC, right? Where this P is D by DT. This entire term we are talking about, or this term we are talking about. Okay, so now we'll convert this into DQ reference frame. So this will become, so VDQ, right? Consider maybe zero, VDQ zero. So this is how to write this. Or in other words, so this is your transformation matrix KS, and you have another KS transformation matrix. This is P into lambda ABC. It's clear. So now, so we have this DQ zero only. So I want to move this to this other side. So how this equation changes, KS P into KS inverse. KS inverse lambda, so this is not, it's lambda Q D zero. So this is lambda, not Q D zero, DQ zero. This is lambda DQ zero. This is correct? Is correct?
So KS must be inside now, sir.
Mm-hmm.
KS must be inside and KS inverse must be outside. Is it not like that?
You can write it anywhere. This KS inverse in the inside or KS inverse in the outside. Okay.
Oh.
But
oh,
that
okay.
Matrix is having, for you need to multiply the matrix, right? So therefore you need to maintain that KS inverse on the other side.
Okay.
So this can be written like this. So this is P into, that is D by DT into two variables. So that is integration of the first variable. So the differentiation of the first variable, so this is in the integration of x into y form, right? So this x into y, not dxy by dt. So this x into dy by dt form plus y into dx by dt form. So when you are doing this, so what you will get is, so this is Ks. So this is Ks, this P into, or this differentiation of Ks inverse into lambda DQ zero, that is the first term. And so now we are differentiating this Ks into Ks inverse, this one, lambda DQ zero. Okay, so that means we are differentiating this entire term. Sorry, not entire term. We are differentiating this term. And after that, we are differentiating this term. Is clear? So first we are differentiating this Ks inverse term. And after that, plus we are differentiating this only lambda DQ zero term. So when you are doing this, so it will be in this form. So V DQ zero, or with this VDQ zero, if you are neglecting that, so it will be omega lambda QD plus rho into, or this D by DT into lambda DQ zero. This is in this form, this is lambda DS. So it is in the form of minus lambda DS. The minus lambda QS, and this is plus lambda DS. I think you remember this, right? No? Remember this? So that means if you are rewritten like this, or if you are separating these terms, so this dq, it will be minus of omega ls iqs plus p into, this is lambda, it consists of l into I, right? So that means this is ls into ids. That is the one term. And another term is vq is, right? This vq is, omega ls ids plus p into ls I qs. Okay. So these are, if you, this is d axis variable, right? So this is also ds, but this one is q axis. Okay. So this one is q axis. So therefore, if you remember that when you're modeling the induction machine or anything, right? So we will represent these as, how we are represent these? You represent these as a voltage sources, right? You represent these as a voltage sources. So that is dependent voltage sources. In this modeling, so we are representing these as a dependent voltage sources. So this is also dependent voltage source when you're actually doing this, right? So this is Q axis variable, but here you have this D axis component. So here also you have this Q axis, but this entire thing will normally represent a dependent variable in this form. You remember this or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right. Okay, I think these are correct. Okay, you can cross verify when it is wrong. So where we are, so here we are, right? So with the same thing, if you rewrite like this, so it will be in this form. So these things will be in this form. So that is, we are actually integrating this one, right? So now it will be, so it's some ls into d it, some dq by dt plus j omega, or simply omega lt into dq form. I t dq form. Or in other words, you can simply replace these equations. So whatever the equations that we are obtained, right? So these are the grid voltages. So we are talking about, right? So that means simply we have this, these are grid voltages, right? And this is the terminal current. So now this will become GTD. And this is G. Q, and where is this current? This is IQS. Okay, this ITQ, and this one will become ITD. This is also ITD, and this is ITQ. Okay. So these are corresponding to the terms. So these are corresponding to the terms. The differentiation part of inductor. Okay. So when you are adding this one in this equation, so we have developed these equations, right? So this is the dq equation. So in this equation, so whatever that this part, right? So this part is, I have written in these two equations. This part I have written. in these two equations. So therefore, this overall equations in terms of this t, so it will be VTD, right? So that is the terminal voltage. So it can be write like this, some RS. So this is the voltage we are discussing, right? This is VTD. So RS into, or RS ITD, this component. So this is minus omega LS ITQ plus P into LS ITD. Okay. So what is left here? This one. So this is VTD. This is not VTD, right? These are grid voltages. So don't be confused. So this is, we are separating these two terms, right? I will write like here. So this is VTD, right? This component. So this is VGDQ. So this is VZD. So this first term is RS, okay? And this is ITD. So this entire term, right, for this D axis, so this is the one, right? So now this is minus omega LS, minus omega LS into ITQ plus P into LS ITD. Plus, so this term, so this is VTD. Okay, similarly, the grid voltages, this Q component, same, this is RS into ITQ, right, plus omega LS into ITD plus P into LS ITQ plus VTQ. Is clear? Is clear? Is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have separated this D axis term and Q axis term. We have separated the D axis and Q axis terms. Okay. So from this, so let us represent, or let us take out this ITD term and this ITQ term. Okay, so let us take this ITD and this ITQ terms. So for that, or if you want to draw a block diagram for this one, so to extract this ITD and this ITQ terms, ITD and this ITQ terms. Okay. So if you write ITD equation, so it should be start from this VGD minus this VTD, right? So therefore, so you have a block like this. So this is VTD, and here this is VGD. Okay. Yeah. And here, whatever that remaining is there, the differentiation is there. So we have three terms. So one is the RS term minus omega LS term, and another one is P LS terms. So first we have this RS term, and second we have this one by this omega LS terms, right? So this is LS terms, right? This is in the integration form. So that means it will be, or if you are taking this on the other side, so it will be, how it will be? this is P into LS, okay, and the other term is minus omega LS. Minus omega LS, so this is into ITQ, right? Similarly, you have the other term. So this is VTQ and this is VGQ term. Again, you have three things. So this is RS term and this is PLS term and this one is omega LS term. Okay. So now come to these equations. Okay. So now come to these equations. So which one? This is omega minus omega LS into ITQ, right? So minus omega LS into ITQ. So therefore, so this term, so that means this term, so this is the error between these two, right? So that means this term will go, or this term will multiply, so these two will be come like this, okay? So this term will be multiplied, this whatever this is, if you assume that this is ITD, and similarly these two, if you are multiply these two, and this is ITQ. So that means this term will be multiplied to here, okay? This term is multiplied here and this term is multiplied here. Okay, just representing these equations in a block diagram form, that's it. Okay, this is correct. Is this correct? So here this VDQ, so therefore here you have this minus sign. Okay. So here you have this minus sign here. So here also minus sign, this is plus minus, and this RS, so this is minus here. Okay, so when you're moving this on other side, and this is minus here, and here you have minus. Okay. And so when you're writing this one, this is plus omega LS. I think this is only omega LS. Okay, since we are considering minus here. Okay, so this is the entire thing. So to obtain this ID, ITD and ITQ. Okay, if you are not understanding this one, you just simply write, so what is ITD? So in this, so what is the expression for ITD? So with this one, what is the expression for ITD? So this is VGD minus VTD. Okay, so what is left here? So if you write like this and you have separated this RS, or if you take common of this ITD term, if you take common, so it will be RS plus P into LS, okay, RS into P into LS, and you have this extra term, so that is omega, right? So this extra term is omega LS into I TQ. Is this correct? Is this correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Similarly, this is VGQ minus VTQ. So this is ITQ into RS plus P into LS minus of, sorry, not minus, this plus of, right? Omega LS into IT D. Okay. The same thing I'm trying to write, so in this equation form. So now you can cross verify, so whether this is correct or not. You can cross verify this. So this is the first term, right? This is the first term from this. You can have another one. So this is ITD. Okay. So this is VGD minus VTQ. Right. So this is on the other side. If you so this plus omega LS into ITQ. So we have this term RS plus P into LS. So we are adding here this P into LS, RS plus P into LS, we are adding here. And this other term, so this is omega LS, and it is obtaining from this ITQ. Again, this one, this omega LS, again, I'm taking from this one, and I am multiplying with this omega, this term, this variable, right? Okay. So now we are obtained this ITD and ITQ. So these are the currents. So these are the currents that required, or this current in the inverter. So come to this one. Right. So we, one of the class we discussed that, right. See, in one of the class when you are discussing the synchronous PI controller, so we are discussing these, right? If you remember that, when you are discussing the synchronous PI controller scheme, so we have the source currents. So source currents are converted to ABC to alpha beta, from alpha beta to DQ, and you will get this ISD and ISQ. Okay. So here you will get this ISD and ISQ. Okay. So the difference is whatever you done with that method, right? So whatever that you have done this one, so this is your ISD and ISQ. So both are same. Okay. So this is one voltage approach, and this is direct measurement. If you notice that, so here we are not measuring any currents. So this is in, you're not measuring any currents. So indirectly we are obtaining the inverter currents. So whereas here, so you are directly measure the currents. So from that currents, we are actually transforming into DQ reference frame. Right. So what is the next step is these currents, we are comparing with this ISD and this ISQ. So these are the reference inverter currents. So these are the reference inverter currents. Okay. So now the next thing is how to obtain these reference inverter currents. How to obtain the reference inverter currents. So next one is how to obtain this reference inverter currents in DQ reference frame. Okay. So we have this formula for what is the P and what is formula for Q in case of DQ reference frame. What is the formula for P and Q? Instantaneous active power and instantaneous reactive power. What is the formula? You might have studied this, right? So this is VD, right? So VD ID plus VQ IQ is the active power. Similarly, this VD into IQ minus VQ into ID is the instantaneous reactive power. You studied this, right? Okay. So when you are studying the power invariance of this DQ reference frame, so you might have seen these equations. So when you have power invariance, so this is power invariance. So that means when this, right? So when you are selecting the transformation coefficient as root 2 by 3. Then you're selecting the transformation coefficient as root 2 by 3. Or if you're selecting the transformation coefficient as 2 by 3, so how these equations will change? So P will become, so here you will get, I think here you will get 3 by 2 into this VD ID plus VQ IQ. And this is Q is, again, this 3 by 2 VD IQ minus VQ ID. Okay. So this is transformation coefficient. You remember that, right? So in you have this 2 by 3 and cos theta, cos omega theta minus 120 degrees or something like this. We have this, right? So if you select this root 2 by 3, so these are the formula for the instantaneous active and instantaneous reactive power. So if you are selecting this 2 by 3, that is for voltage invariance. So these are the formula for 2 by 3, that is 3 by 2 and 3 by 2, right? Yeah, so this is the powers or instantaneous powers in PQ reference frame, or active power and reactive power in, sorry, not PQ, this alphabet DQ reference frame, right? So you know that, so when the reference frame is balanced, or this, when the voltages are balanced and the reference frame is aligned with the A axis, in other words, this D axis is aligned with A axis, so under these cases this VQ will become zero, right? Under these cases this VQ will become zero, so therefore you're left with, so this P is VD ID and this Q is VQ IQ. So this P is VD ID and this Q is VQ IQ. So these are the, if you are considering, these are the inverter powers, or this actual power, or actual real and reactive power. So that is controlled by the grid. So this is the formula for the real and reactive power. So that is supposed to be controlled by the grid. Okay. So now, so you have two options, right? For first, for real power. And you have another two options for reactive power, right? So first, for in case of real power, you can keep this, you can inject a particular amount of real power into the grid. You can inject a particular amount of real power into the grid, right? So that is one way. And the other way is, the second way is to maintain a, right? So to maintain a DC voltage constant across a particular load. So the first one is, so directly inject some quantity of real power, inject some direct quantity of real power, right? And second one is regulate DC voltage across load. So regulate DC voltage across load. So meaning is, right. So for example, I want to inject some 10 kilowatt of real power into grid by using some PV application. I want to inject some 10 kilowatt real power into the grid by using some PV application. So that means the inverter is feeding, or inverter is fed from a PV. So in that case, so how your ID will changes. So that means we have this P. So now this is 10 kilowatt, right? So this, we will divide this one. So with this VD, so that gives you this ID star. Okay. In other words, when you're multiplying this VD and ID, it's supposed to be 10 kilowatt. So that means that your current D axis current will be, right, your D axis reference current supposed to be 10 kilowatt divided by this VD. Okay, so this VD is usually the grid voltages. So then only 10 kilowatt of real power is actually fed to the grid. Right, so another one is regulate the DC voltage across the load. In case of some applications where you are keeping the DC voltage constant, so like battery chargers, so we are keeping the voltage across the battery constant. So in this case, so we have this VDC reference, and this is VDC actual, right? So this is VDC reference, and this is VDC actual, and we have this PI controller, so that PI controller, so that will decide the VD star, or the reference active power, or this reference D axis component. So that must be injected, or that must be drawn from the inverter, so that this DC voltage is maintained constant. Okay, so this is the first approach, and this is the second approach. Clear? So we can directly control the active power and reactive power. So in case of active power, so there are two options. So that all depends on your application. So that all depends on, so what is there on the DC side. If it is PV, right, in case of PV, we are normally control the output voltage or output power of the PV. So based on that, you can inject some certain amount of real power into the grid. In case of applications like battery chargers or some motor drive applications, where we are likely to keep the DC voltage constant, so in that case, so that gives you, that means V reference minus this V actual, so into in PI controller, so that gives you the ID reference. Okay. So come to this reactive power. Again, this reactive power. So generally, this reactive power is not required, right? So therefore, we can directly make this reactive power to zero. That means, so this ID star or this reference will be zero in this case. This ID star will be, or this IQ star will be zero. Or in case of applications like induction generator or induction, that means wind generation, sometimes you require some reactive power, right? Sometimes you require some reactive power. So under that, to reactive power from the grid. So therefore, you can have this reactive power, that is Q star, not this capital Q, this is Q star. Okay, so this we need to divide by 1 by this VQ. And this is wrong, actually. So this is not VQ. This is the first term, right? This VQ is zero. So therefore, this is not VQ. So this is VD. Okay. So we are dividing with this, with VD. So that gives you the IQ star. Okay. So here, what we are trying to discuss is, we are trying to inject some certain amount of real power and reactive power into the grid, right? So it may be injection, or it may be drawing, right? So here, if you know that, see the same thing, right? For the same application, if it is trying to, the power flow is from the grid to the the load cell, right? So nothing will change. So here, whatever this is P, right? So this is the real power P. So just instead of P, it just make it minus P, right? So in that case, the power flow will be in the opposite direction. Okay, so now we are trying to control or trying to inject certain amount of active and certain amount of reactive power into the grid. So that dictates the inverter currents in DQ reference frame, or inverter or expected inverter currents in DQ reference frame. Right. So the first approach is either we can keep the power constant or voltage across the DC side constant. If you keep the power constant, so that means it simply divide with the VD value, so that gives you this ID star. Right. In the second approach, we can keep the voltage across the capacitor or voltage across the DC, voltage on the DC side, we are keeping it constant. So for that, you require some additional PI controller. So that gives you the, we need to measure the actual DC voltage and we'll compare with the reference value, and after PI processing, that will give you the ID star. So remember that we cannot do these two things simultaneously. So meaning is that you cannot control active power, you cannot control P, you can do only either this one or this one. We cannot do both things. So why we can't do this both things means, in case of this one, right, so the amount of real power, so that is, in case if you assume that this is DC side, right, let us assume that the load resistance is R. So how much amount of power, so that will be injected here is, so this is VDC reference square by R. So this much of amount of power, so that will be injected. So in this second case, so whereas here, so when you are doing in this case, so here this VDC is always varying, or this voltage across is always varying. This voltage across this DC side is always varying, depends on this P value. Okay. Right. So in case of reactive power, so in most of the cases we'll keep this reactive power as zero. Right. If it's a STATCOM applications or DSTATCOM applications, so we normally keep this as zero. But in some cases where we have some voltage stability is there, so generally in case of voltage stability, or especially in case of induction generator application, or in case of wind applications, we will normally keep some reactive power. So under such cases, so this is so how the reactive power is maintained. Okay, so Q star, that is the required reactive power that need to be drawn from the grid, or that must be injected into the grid to make the grid stable. Okay, to make the grid stable, if you want to inject some reactive power, so this one, so that means just divide this with VQ, so that gives you the Q axis component of the expected inverter currents. Okay, this is how we will generate this reference currents in DQ axis. This is how we will generate in DQ axis. Okay, we will continue in the next class. See if you have any questions here. You have any questions? I hope you are able to understand all this.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these are some new things you might not studied earlier. But these are required. Okay. So if you have any questions, you can ask me.
Sir, can you explain that diagram of ITD?
This one? This diagram?
On right side.
This one?
This one, sir.
This is just simple diagram, okay? Just draw this equation.
VGD minus VDQ, VTD, and here you have taken VTD minus VGD.
See, forget about this diagram, whether it's right or wrong. So the idea is to extract this ITD, and our idea is to develop a circuit for, or develop some model for these equations. Okay. Right.
Okay, sir.
Okay. I think some plus or minus corrections are there. So I will provide that. Okay. So the idea is to generate this ITD and ITQ from the grid voltages and this component omega and RS. This grid voltages is the input, right? And this RS and LS are the other inputs. From these, you are actually calculating the inverter currents. You're actually calculating the inverter currents, right? So instead of that, doing all these things, you can directly measure the inverter currents and transform it into DQ transformations. Okay. So this is voltage controlled approach. So we have studied that, right? Current controlled approach and voltage controlled approach. In case of current controlled approach, we need to measure the currents, right? We need to measure the inverter currents. In case of voltage control methods, no need to measure the inverter currents. We need to estimate the inverter currents. The same thing we are doing here, but in DQ reference frame. Okay. So earlier also we estimated the inverter currents in ABC reference frame, right? You remember those equations for unity power factor. The same thing we are doing in DQ reference frame. That's the difference. Okay. So in next class we'll study, so how these actual one and how that reference one, so we need to implement in a closed loop or thing.
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, that last point, can you please repeat, sir, about you were talking about VDC square by R. What is
this
that,
one?
Sir? Yes, sir, that last.
So this is the power, right? If this is the, for example, we have this inverter is there, okay? So this is AC side, and we are trying to make this a constant, right? We have connected load here. So let us assume that load resistance is R. Okay, so how much power, or ideally it's supposed to draw? How much power it's supposed to draw? V square by R, right?
Yes, sir.
So here this V square by R, in other words, this is VDC reference square by R. So that is the amount of real power. So that is, it is consuming, right? Okay, the same thing I have written here.
Yes, so that Q is zero. That is actually reference.
That is the?
Reference.
Yeah, it is in ideal case, in steady state case, both reference and it will be same, right? See here, in case of this voltage control method, so you have no control over this P. Okay?
Yes,
so in case of this power as a reference, or in this case power control, so in that case, so you have no control on the VDC value. So that's why it is known as VOC. It is voltage oriented control. Control. So where you are trying to control this P, right? So this is grid, active, and reactive control. So this is known as GARPC or something. Okay. Grid, active, and reactive power control. And this is voltage oriented control. Okay, so what is your question?
No, sir, that VDC ref square by R, where do we actually give it? Is it?
We're not giving that anything, right? Okay,
okay.
I'm just saying that that is the amount of real power
that
it's supposed to draw. So in this case, okay,
yes, sir.
We cannot give this as input.
Okay, okay. Yes,
so when this R is changing, so obviously this P is changing. So my intention is to, so when you are implementing this first one, you cannot maintain the second one, or when you are implementing the second one, so you don't have the control over the first one.
Okay, okay. Yes, sir.
So you can only do one task, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, when you are keeping the voltage constant means, if the load is constant, the power is always constant, irrespective of the power, that is always constant. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, if you have no questions, I will stop. I will provide that diagram and corresponding papers. I will try to download and I will give it to you.